Hi, it's Susanna B. Troy. Here's a Mayor Bloomberg corruption update. The chief is the only one to cover it, front page, that Seedco had to pay New York Gov taxpayers, us, $1.7 million, actually a little bit more than that, $1.7 million in damages for overbilling us. They're supposed to be a nonprofit to help small businesses, but instead, like everybody else, when it comes to New York City government, and I'm sure it goes on from the White House to Albany on down, but it's the worst ever under Michael Bloomberg, they were overbilling us. So we also, as you recall, last year got $450 million cash back from SAIC, although I was the only one to come out right away and say that figure's way too low. In my opinion, it was a backroom deal that SAIC and Bloomberg made to make this go away, when in fact, both Team Bloomberg, Mike Bloomberg, Mark Page, and his administration, and SAIC, starting with Rudy Giuliani's administration, are both guilty of allowing SAIC to rob us. And I wanted a billion. Bierce and Kennison recommended times three for racketeering, which I thought was brilliant. The biggest corruption to date is ECTP 911 tech system, and we do not even have a criminal trial. John Liu asked for one almost a year ago. He did a 20-page audit. He gave it to Cy Vance, and just like the St. Vincent's crooks, Cy Vance has not gotten around to prosecuting the St. Vincent crooks or the 911 tech corruption. Really, what Cy Vance would have to do is hand it over to Preet Bharara, and he hasn't done that. There's a lot more corruption. Mike Bloomberg rewarded a culture of failure. He rewarded a revolving door of corruption, and it means billions of our dollars was abused, stolen, overbilling, and other crimes, and they have not been held accountable. I want all the money back plus damages, and even, for instance, with SAIC, can we go after Deloitte, their auditors, and go after all the Deloitte, you know, all the auditors, but most of all, where are the arrests of New York City government workers? With the exception of Mark Mazur, who was a consultant, actually not a, he used to work for the city. Everybody's got soft landings. Gerard Denault was arrested, and Mazur, no soft landings, but everybody else, amazing. What happened to Sal Salomon? What happened to Joel Bondi? There are people even higher up than them that should be arrested. Mark Mazur and Mark Mazur's crew. So where are the arrests of New York City government officials? And Bloomberg and his people have been protected, and SAIC and the top officials at SAIC have been protected. But shareholders of SAIC are suing SAIC. It's like they read my blog, fixed all the typos and grammatical mistakes, and that's their lawsuit, derivative lawsuit, and SAIC is trying to get it thrown out, and we're hoping they do not, because essentially it is the OJ trial in reverse. It's bad news for Mike Bloomberg, and I was the only one to report that Preet Bharara has pushed back CityTime trial yet again. I call it the trial of the century, next century. It may be pushed back enough that when Mike Bloomberg, I hope, is called to testify by Gerald Chagall and Barry Bauer, that Mike will no longer be mayor, and Preet Bharara will be forced to give him immunity. And I bet you Mike will commit perjury, just like he did during the Hagerty trial. A sitting mayor committed perjury. Mike also broke campaign laws. That's a misdemeanor A. Wake up, New Yorkers, and thank you for following me. By the way, I made a new analogy. I said the NYPD fighting crime, the NYPD crime statistics are like a Las Vegas casino. The fix is in, it's a numbers game. And now I'm handing out these cards. Go to YouTube, search Dr. Fagelman Assault. Watch me be violently assaulted by Dr. Andrew Fagel's receptionist. The NYPD did not arrest her. I went to get a cyst removed on my arm and left with a bleeding around my eye. In my eye, there was a hole in the retina, neck damage. Thank you for watching the beginning of the assault. She also grabbed my hair and would not let go. After hitting me three times, I defended myself. She also kicked me in the groin and barely made contact. She was not fired or arrested. NYPD says crime is down. Not true. NYPD fixing crime. Welcome to violent New York City. There is nothing a patient can do to warrant being menaced, stalked, and then violently assaulted. She also said she was going to slap the crap out of me. There's nothing I or anybody could do to provoke that kind of road rage. I'm just lucky there wasn't a subway running through there, because I probably would have been shoved. It was out of control. In my opinion, it was a horrific experience. And it's not over for me, not by a long shot. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you.